Let me start by just describing what this thing was. And we have a case study live on our website, so people can go read that if they want. But, you know, it started with screens. Digital screens were showing up across the MTA network. And that meant installations in subway stations so that when you're waiting for the train, you can see, you know, messaging and advertisements. But it also meant, you know, screens on tracks for the suburban railroad stations. And it meant screens on buses. And eventually it will mean screens on train cars and subway cars. And so it was just, you know, this is not just like 10 or 20 screens. This is tens of thousands of screens that are getting deployed across this network. And the MTA was unsure about how to deal with getting messaging to riders in a timely, efficient way across this vast network. They just didn't deal with it before.
Right. So the tools were lacking in terms of broadcasting or narrowcasting to different screens across thousands
of screens. That's right. And even the non-screen channels were very dumb. Like, it was like, okay, we need to post to Twitter, make sure there's a box for Twitter. We need to post to the website, make sure there's a box for the website. And so literally the interfaces that we saw were, you know, eight text boxes next to each other, eight text areas. And it was like, go nuts, communications person. And one of the insights that we took from your work, Rich, early on was, let's think about this more thoughtfully. This is not just one text box per output. It is, how do we create really strong data that can be transformed to go really seamlessly into all these various places? And yes, that really helps with screens, but it also helps publishing a data feed that can be consumed by Google Maps or the MTA's website or its trip planner, that kind of thing.
As a technologist, I mean, I sort of started to sort of sketch out the high level architectural approach to this before you guys came on. So it resonates for everyone on this podcast right now. But Gina, how do you like translate that into a message that resonates for the MTA? The MTA, a huge, sprawling public organization.
You know, you look at every client engagement, I like to think of it in two parts, right? There's pre-kickoff and there's post-kickoff. Pre-kickoff, you're in sell mode. You're saying, hi, we're your partner. We can help you out. We've got technology and we can help you out. Mm-hmm. And Rich drove this mostly, and I got to attend some of the meetings. But I was there in the presentation when Rich said, we're going to create pure data and we're going to transform it on a pure channel basis. And it's going to be future-proofed and it's going to be clean and fast, et cetera. You're presenting a low fidelity vision for what you're doing to executives, right? But then they say, okay, yes, we want to do this. Let's go. And you have a contract and then you kick off. Now you're post kickoff and you're in a totally different mode, which is now we have to make this happen. And suddenly all the details of all the things and all the people and all the needs and all the opinions and all the old systems and all the workflows that everyone's so attached to, like, bubble to the surface. And you're just like, there's a moment of slight terror. When you're like, oh, we have a profile, like, we're on the fulfillment side now and we've got to make this happen. So the way that you make this happen is just, I mean, to begin with, it's weeks. It was 6 weeks of conversations with getting to know everybody in the org, getting to know the nouns and the verbs. I started writing a dictionary that was like, you know, hundreds of terms, just understanding.
A lot of acronyms.
A lot of, so many acronyms, just understanding like the landscape.